Hey guys, welcome back to Glamorized Beauty by Sashes. Today is going to be all about Urban Decay. If you didn't check out my last video about the Urban Decay 15th anniversary palette, go check that out before you watch this. That way you won't be confused. So if you watched that video, you know what happened with my palette. And you see what I have here, and I did not open it. It has not been opened, and it just came today. So let's see. Moment of truth. Okay. All systems go. So this is how it comes. It comes packaged with the little UD on the top in this box with, you know, the traces of like Nira and the beautiful little designs on the side. Then you lift it and you have 15 shadows. Look like this. Okay, now even though I know I told you guys to go buy this palette, I still think that this is an amazing deal, and I still think that you should go get it. But after looking at it a little more, even though I've been dying for them to come out with a black wax, let me grab something really quick. Okay, so when the naked palette came out, I died to get the naked palette. Like, literally died to get the naked palette. And if you don't have it, this is what it looks like. And it is an amazing palette. I'm not even gonna lie. This is great for if you're doing bridal work, neutrals. It's just an amazing palette. It was 12 colors in here. But what I'm trying to get to is, as I like looked at the palette really good, even though there's like a lot of pretty colors and all of the colors are new, it's a lot of neutral colors. All of these are neutral. All of these are neutral. One line of brights. Well, you can consider it brights. The only thing that's really bright would be the pink. And they just had a pink release with the rollerblade palette, I want to say. And this teal. And that teal is really pretty. I can't recall offhand like a teal from Urban Decay. But if you look at all of this, just look at that right there. All of that is neutral. It looks, you know, kind of, you know, really close to the colors that you could have in your neutral palette. All of those are neutral. And then on this side, all of those are like the darker grays and the darker chocolates and stuff. But I am kind of excited about Blackout because I've been dying for Urban Decay to come out with the deep black eyeshadow. And this is definitely it. Let's swatch that and see. So that's Blackout. Chase, let's just go by each one. Midnight Rodeo, and I'm pulling out palettes here. I have my Book of Shadows here. I'm trying to do some comparison so we can see what we got here. Okay, Midnight Rodeo, the closest color I would have to compare that to would have to be Smog. Midnight Rodeo is a shade lighter and it has glitter in it. So this is Midnight Rodeo. And I'm just gonna swatch Smog. And this is Smog. So those two are really, really close in colors. This one is a bit darker, but really close in colors. Another one that looks kind of comparable. Deeper. This one, which is deeper, reminds me a lot of Smog from the Naked palette. And Smog is right here. This is Smog here and Deeper. Those two really remind me of each other in color. For the purple, Junk Show looks a lot similar to Mayhem, and I'm going to swatch them too. This is Mayhem, and this is from the Book of Shadows. and this is, I'm sorry, this is Omen. Look at those two. You can't, it's like, if you were to wear those two together, it would look like the same color. The only thing is, this Omen reminds me a lot of Stars and Rockets because it has kind of like a purpley, metallic-y pink undertone, and Mayhem is just a really pretty purple, but those two together, you truly wouldn't be able to tell that the colors were different. That's just my opinion. The gray, I was happy to see a pretty gray because the gunmetal in this palette I do not like too much. Vanilla is a really pretty color. It kind of reminds me of that a pigment I had that color. Just a really pretty color. I don't know how or where I would use that just on my tone, but it is a really gorgeous color. Really gorgeous color. Tainted is kind of like a pale pinkish color. I don't think I would do much with that just on my skin tone, and that's right here. Just on me, just because of my tone, like for somebody lighter than me, probably would do great things with that. A really pretty pale pink with kind of purpley undertones. That's how that one looks. That's about it. I really don't have any more comparisons I'm going to compare Tainted to Graffiti from the Book of Shadows. This is Graffiti here. This is Graffiti right here. And those two look pretty similar as well. This is Tainted from the 15 year anniversary palette. And this is Graffiti from the Book of Shadows. Like I said, once again, if you put those two colors on your eyes together, you would not be able to tell the difference in them. It's just that Graffiti is chopped full of glitter and the other one is not. So, like I said, I love Urban Decay. Urban Decay cannot do any wrong. But they're kind of, I hate to say it, kind of like repeating the colors. Just like either taking away a little bit of color or adding a little bit of color. But still sticking with the same kind of, still sticking in that same genre of colors that they're used to providing. And we all love Urban Decay and the texture. But I just wish they would have switched it up a little bit and added like some funky new colors, or colors that we haven't seen, or colors that aren't so close to colors that we already own. You know, I mean, they say if it's not broke, don't fix it. But anybody would love just, you know, a little pop of color, some adventure, something new. Maybe like a purple, like a brilliant purple, like I'm talking about a purple, or I don't know. I honestly think that this palette was more about the presentation than anything else in the shadows. And it's kind of funny how they placed them in there, how they did all of the super light neutral colors here, then they did the darker colors here in order from light to darkest, what I thought was kind of weird. And then they kind of did the same thing over here. When you got to the end, you got your neutrals, your mid-tones, which is a gray, and you have this black, and then you have this color here, which is a deep purple. I could have truly did without Midnight Rodeo, Midnight 15. I kind of love Flow, so I would keep Flow. I could have kept vanilla, but I could have definitely done without Flow, and I could have definitely done without Chase, and they could have like mixed it up and did something outside of the Urban Decay box. Okay, so that is my full in-depth review on the Urban Decay 15 year anniversary eyeshadow palette, and I'm definitely gonna do some looks using it. So if you have any questions, feel free to comment below. Please let me know how you feel about what I said, and also how you feel about the palette and the colors and how they place the colors and stuff like that. So I will see you guys next video.